way. Wherever I go, hard luck is there to stay. Good luck never stays a day. Bad luck's always a coming my way.
Welcome back to It's a Grim Life, the daily vlog of the Grim Life Collective. Today, for today's bizarre, weird, strange journey, Amy and I are here at the CDC here in Atlanta. Now, we are in the visitor parking garage. I don't know if you can see right behind me. It says visitor parking, non-CDC employee. So we are really here. Now, I do not know what they are going to let us film on the inside, but I'm going to try to get as much as possible. In order to get onto the grounds, we had to do, we had to pull up to the checkpoint, open up all the doors, the trunk of the car, the hood of the car, and they inspected everything, and we had to sign waivers in order to get here. But if you did not know, like I said, there is a museum here, and we are going to check it out. So let's go see what we can find. Well, as it turns out, we are allowed to film in here and take photos, so let's explore properly, shall we? So we got our visitor badges here for the CDC, and we are about to explore the museum. Let's go.
I was working in the lab late one night, when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from its slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise, he did the monster mash. It was a graveyard smash. It caught on in a flash. He did the monster mash.
Disease detectives. The Epidemic Intelligence Service. This is pretty neat. What you see here on the wall is a radiogram, Worldwide Wireless. This is from November 20th, 1924, stating one case of chickenpox in San Francisco. Check it out. In the 1940s and 50s, an epidemic of polio caused widespread panic in America. Here's the old pictures. VD chain of infection. Kind of upside down for this one, but these are called Shepherd tubes. Public health workers use these tubes to draw blood to be tested for VD. Amy has pointed out that the contents of this jar look like pee, but we assure you it is not. We didn't check thoroughly, though. It is actually, the contents of this jar is water obtained by the CDC in, obtained by the CDC while in Philadelphia investigating the Bellevue Stratford Hotel as a Legionnaires outbreak. This is chiller water. Now the bacteria inside it is no longer active, but it is here. The original specimen is here to be viewed upon. It is not pee. Rats, an urban plague. Swine flu vaccine. We did not know that the swine flu vaccine was this old. This is 1976 this vaccine was created. 1976. Well, we can't get close to them, but right back there, hanging on that wall in that room, are some actual suits that the people from the CDC wear when they go into some place that is questionable in order to try to find out what is going on. The disease suits. I don't know what else to call them other than the disease suits. Right back there. Can you see them? What a point of, like, let's crush their head. There you go. But right there. I don't mean to make light of this kind of situation. It's just the way my mind works, but that is pretty neat. I was looking through them. I knew that they were here, but sadly we can't get to them because they are locked behind this wall. This is a glass wall, some sort of classroom, some sort of teaching thingamadoo in there. And we can't get into there, and I'm picking up my papers because I am a brochure collector. Let's see here. Worms. 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 They have a section here on Three Mile Island that happened in Middleton, Pennsylvania. It was a nuclear power plant accident. I'm from Pennsylvania. I remember this. I mean, it happened before I was born in, what, 1979? I was born in 79. But I do remember hearing about this. There it is. Pretty crazy, right? Pretty darn crazy. And there's so much countless things that you can read here. I mean, so many interesting things. So I feel very lucky and very privileged that we are actually here in this museum. And lucky that we can video and put something together for anybody who is interested in the CDC. And if you did not know, here in Atlanta, this is the CDC Museum. And it's pretty awesome, pretty neat. This is probably my favorite piece in this whole museum. It's this iron lung. It was used for polio patients. Back in the 50s, your whole body would be in here if you were suffering from polio. And your head, your whole body would be inside this thing, but your head would be sticking out here. And this has got to be pretty scary. As you can see behind here, all these people, all these patients in that picture, all the nurses, I mean, look at them all these people inside these iron lungs. It's crazy. You wouldn't find me in there. Not at all. I need to go find Amy. There is Amy. Come here, Amy. It is almost time for us to go. So we gotta say goodbye.
Bye.
Bye. Until tomorrow, thank you for joining us again here at the CDC Museum here in Atlanta, Georgia. Have a good night.
Achoo.
Achoo.
They call me a calamity man, but I'm trying as hard as I can to keep a bad luck away from me. I'm doomed to win the lottery. Deal with misery.